गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 9th सिविक सब्जेक्ट। चैप्टर इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डिजाइन। कंटेंट्स आर इंट्रोडक्शन, डेमोक्रेटिक कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इन साउथ अफ्रीका, स्ट्रगल अगेंस्ट अपार्थाइड एंड लास्ट टॉपिक इज टुवर्ड्स अ न्यू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। Introduction. In this chapter, we will study some basic things about the constitutional design of a democracy. Why do we need a constitution? Who designed them and in what way? What are the values that shape the constitution in democratic states? Once a constitution is accepted, we can make changes later as required by the changing conditions. We begin this chapter with South Africa. What happened there and how South African designed their constitution. Then we turn to how the Indian constitution was made. Democratic constitution in South Africa. Nelson Mandela was the leader of the South Africa. He did a struggle to get freedom from white people. He and 7 other leaders were sentenced to life imprisonment in 1946. For daring to oppose the apartheid regime in his country. He has spent 28 years in South Africa's most dreaded prison, Robben Island. Struggle against apartheid. Apartheid was the name of a system of racial discrimination unique to South Africa. The white Europeans imposed this system on South Africa. During the 17th and 18th century, the trading companies from Europe occupied it with arms and force, in the way they occupied India. But unlike India, a large number of whites had settled in South Africa. The system of apartheid divided the people and labeled them on the basis of their skin color. The native people of South Africa are black in color. They made up about 3/4 of the population and were called blacks. Besides these two groups, there were people of mixed races who were called colored, and people who migrated from India. The white rulers treated all non-whites as inferiors. The non-whites did not have voting rights. The apartheid system was particularly oppressive for the blacks. They were forbidden from living in white areas. They could work white areas only if they had a permit. Trains, buses, taxis, hotels, hospitals, schools and colleges, libraries, cinema halls, theaters, beaches, swimming pools, public toilets were all separate for the whites and blacks. This was called segregation. Since 1950, the blacks, colored and Indians fought against the apartheid system. They launched protests, marches and strikes. The African National Congress, ANC, was the umbrella organization that led the struggle against the policies of segregation. This included many workers, unions and the Communist Party. Many sensitive whites also joined the ANC to oppose apartheid and played a leading role in this struggle. Several countries denounced apartheid as unjust and racist, but the white racist government continued to rule by detaining, torturing and killing thousands of blacks and colored people. Towards a new constitution. As protests and struggles against apartheid had increased, the white government realized that they could no longer keep the blacks under their rule through repression. The white rulers changed its policies. Discriminatory laws were repealed, ban on political parties and restrictions on the media were lifted. After 28 years of imprisonment, Nelson Mandela walked out of the jail as a free man. Finally, at the midnight of 26th April in 1994, the new national flag of the Republic of South Africa was unfurled, making the newly born democracy in the world. The apartheid government came to an end. After 2 years of discussion and debate, they came out with one of the finest constitution the world has ever had. This constitution gave its citizens the most extensive rights available in any country. This is the preamble of South Africa. Thank you.